So I guess it's time for a new status report. Let's go to my shell. So this is basically the virtual machine, the guest, and it's enforcing. And basically, the user directory of the restricted user is empty. Home, at least empty. Login user, pretty empty. The only bash is basically the stuff that it installs when you it installs when you create a user, so it's pretty empty. And PS aux grep my login shows no processes if all is well. Yeah, no processes, so there's nothing there. And I basically made this user a super user from traditional Linux perspective. So groups my login user will show that my login user is member of the wheel group, so in that sense he is a super user, and hopefully I can actually demonstrate how that affects. I haven't tested that, but hopefully that works the way I expect it to work. So let's just log in. We're in a forcing mode, so here we are, and it's just cleanly booted up. No AVC denials shown up. So let's just verify that at 1345, I guess. Out search M AVCTS 1345, and I'm not saying this policy is perfect, but I'm just showing you that at least logging in doesn't give you any AVC denials. Now, one of the nice things, first I'll show you, is that although the system has a lot of applications and stuff, it doesn't show them for this user, because this user doesn't have access to all the applications. So all the stuff that he doesn't have access to is not displayed. So basically here in this manual, it only shows you the file browser, because that's the only thing that he's able to use. And that's courtesy of the outlet access permission. You can basically, GNOME shell actually just checks all the executables, and if it can't access them, then it won't show them in the menu. So it only shows you the stuff that you can actually use. Now, some of this doesn't make sense. For example, the DNSSEC trigger doesn't quite make sense, because that's enabled in GNOME session, so it's automatically started, although I can't actually get that. My bar where it should show up, I can't get that to show. I'm not sure if there's a key that I can press that it will show the bar, the lower bar where it. And this probably won't work. Well, the change backgrounds might actually work. I'm not sure. Let's try that. Doesn't work. That doesn't work. So yeah, it's not perfect by far. Settings doesn't work either. Doesn't show any AVC denials though. Less for log message. GNOME background panel and GNOME controls could not be loaded. Not sure why I'm not getting any AVC denials there. It should give me AVC denials, actually. At least show me some stuff, same here. Doesn't actually see it, doesn't show me anything, but it also doesn't give me AVC denials, I guess. No. So that outlet access really that is weird, because it's actually executing it and not. That's the outer access. I really somehow I can't get my head around that for some reason. But anyway, and date and time. Let's see if that doesn't work either. But it doesn't show you any. It just doesn't work. See, but no AVC denials at all. It just doesn't work. So the stuff that's displayed actually does work. So should work. For example, keys shows the keys. Should be able to run that. So I'm running that. So let's just create a new key. A PTP key. Next. My login. User, nice with capitals, and then email address, my login user at third, I guess, because that's just an identity, and tests, and then advanced key options. Now I'm going to use these defaults because it's just for an example, and just, and then here password. ABC123, keep it simple. And then it's generating a key. So that should work by default. I need to generate some entropy, you know it. In my previous examples, I went to it as well. Yep, and it shows up. So let's see, ABC denials. No, none yet. So far so good. Seems to be doing everything I like. So secure shell key, create that, and then my login user at vert, and advanced options. That's we keep it simple. And again, the same ABC123. ABC123. And there it is. So now we have two keys there. And let's have a look at the ABC denials. Any? None yet. LSRZ, home, my login user. My login user. And as you can see, we have a GPCG. Directory created, and we have a SSH directory created with proper types, so those are restricted. I can't actually access them manually, so myself, only the programs can do that on my behalf. So we have a key, so let's just try some other stuff. We can actually run a shell, a terminal. So let's open a terminal and let's just verify our identity, and our identity is my login user. So this is basically the actual login user domain. See if we have AVC denials with regard to that. We're still clean, no AVC denials at all. So it can't do much. It probably can top. No, we can't top. And we get an AVC denial. So dismiss the AVC denial and see what's going on there. So there's a bug already. Yeah, okay, I got we need a get chat. So we can just allow that. Nano, my login user type enforcement, and then it's a get set on itself, so we can use that for the accession related, I guess. I'll just add that here. Oh, get set, allow my login user TE self process and get set. get scheduler info self process. Let's make that. So yeah, I'm actually fixing a few bugs here, I guess. User share as a Linux devel make file my login user, and we have a we need a process get shed get sket. So we need to require that require class process get scheduler. So yeah, I'm actually fixing bugs. Not because I might as well do it as a module. E my login. I my login user pp. I might as well fix these bugs while I'm at it. Should be able to top. So and the get schedule. Scheduler isn't such a big issue. So our search, and we're now at 5.7, and we're clean again, hopefully. Yep. So let's try that again. Top. And now it works. See if it have any AVC denials related. None. So that works. And PS AUX shows, and I can even less that if all is well. I tried that and it should work. So yeah, this shows you all the processes here. So we have our bash shell, GPGI helper, we have CR still running here, and all the other processes. Now let's just send a mail, see if the mail works from root. So mail, or actually echo hello, hello, and then pipe that to mail s hello, and then my login user, I guess, and hopefully at some point I will get some new mail. Clear. Ah, now I have new mail, so let's just try the mail. Mail. And I see that, so one. And there's my hello. And delete that message. And quit. This all seems to work. Let's see if there's AVC denials related to that. None. This is all done in a... this is all protected. So I can't actually get to this myself if I would try that, for example, cat, then it would be access denied. See? So only the mail program can do that on my behalf. Anyway, so that's kind of the shell. See, it doesn't have direct access to GPG, whether I should allow that or not. That's something I need to determine. It does have access to SSH. I gave it that earlier in the beginning of my project, and I'm not sure whether I probably should allow the user to manage that stuff. I guess that makes sense. So you can do that. You can actually do some simple stuff. You can probably even create a simple script with the like this, for example, cut test. Actually got test EOF test EOF LS and test. So it can actually do that, and actually the difference between just a normal echo and doing this is that this actually requires the user to create a file in temp, but the user can the user actually list temp? He can't actually list them. So although he was able to create a file in there, he can't actually go there. Now, the file is probably removed now, but let's just see if there's ABC denials first. Yeah, there are some ABC denials here, actually. So we have here cat. Oh, this is the mail spool stuff. And this is my login user getting attributes of tempfs file system, which is for temp. And then it's trying to actually read temp, which is actually the idea is to not allow that. But it can traverse it. But let's have a look at temp. Let's all temp. See if the file's still there. No, it removed it. So, but well, the bash, the script stuff created a file there for that to work. And this here should probably, we should probably allow that. So we could actually do that. Nano. And then to the accession part. And that's where, yeah, accession related. So I'll just add that here. So allow my login user T and I allow it to file system type file system get attribute. So it can get attribute of all file system types. So yeah, I'm just fixing bugs while I'm at it, while I'm demonstrating the functionality. There's always bugs. I should probably just don't audit this one here for reading spool and allow the don't auditing listing temp. But it's nice to see when a user does something that he shouldn't do. If he tries to, for example, read his spool, although it doesn't really make much sense. I could basically don't audit that, but not yet. It's not such a big deal. Anyways, so we're at 1402 actually, and we're clean probably, hopefully. Yeah, we're clean. So that's some stuff that he can actually do. If he couldn't execute that if he wanted to, for example, if it's if it was a script, then he wouldn't be able to run it directly. He would actually do it, probably be able to do it via bash, because I can run bash, can't I? Yeah, I can. So yeah, that's he could run it via bash, a bash shell. And Perl, could he run it? Can he run Perl? No. Well, he can, seems to be able to run it to some extent. Let's have a look at the IOC now. No messages. So why wasn't it just crapping out? I don't know. But anyways, and man, Perl does do manual pages work, no manual page. But anyway, so that's basically with regard to the shell. I'll leave the shell open, so that works to some extent at least. Gedit, let's just check the gedit, really simple, a test file, and then save that. Just save it, and then you'll get the menu here, and I'll just say I'll save it in my documents. That's what you usually do. Save that. Let's see if we have ABC denials with regard to that. Actually, we do. Oh, this is with regard to man. So it was actually not even able to search man pages. Now we could allow that if we wanted to actually. But and actually here the man program wants to, and which is run as the user wants to traverse data home T, which is the local share in the home directory. So, but that's basically something I need to fix. I basically need to make it so that that user can't run binaries, generic binaries. And that's something I need to fix. Yes. Because I don't want that to happen. So let's see, we are at 5, so hopefully we're clean again. So although it doesn't work, he can't run Perl. Well, he can run it, but he just doesn't have enough permissions to run it properly. Okay, so the file, is that file saved actually? So let's open the file manager. And there's this file, and we can actually open it also in gedit. And it's all confined. So, test file, and here's test, which was still open. So, you can just run it. And there it is. Now with regard to Nautilus, so yeah, you can actually browse your home directory. You can actually browse the file system to some extent, although a lot of stuff is basically not accessible. For example, root is not even, yeah, it looks like a file, but it's actually a dir, but and var, you can't actually access that. And but you can actually, well, proc, when there's a lot of crosses and stuff and a lot of access denied. Recent shows the so the recent functionality shows it works. Let's just remove that test file, move it to trash. And as you can see, trash works, empty trash. Let's just go to documents and let's just see what we can do here. So let's just compress it. Let's see if file roller works. We have access to file roller, so I could in theory just and here it is, it's created successfully, and it also gives you a nice icon right there. See if you have plenty of AVC denials or not. Yep, we do. We have Nautilus trying to access a lot of git attribute of readers. We have GVFSD recent trying to open. That test file that we created here in home, my login user. Not sure why it should be able to open it. Let's see if we go to. It doesn't actually show any reasons. This does at least work, but it doesn't show any, well, I'm not sure if it should show any reasons here. So yeah, that at least that works. And we can extract it as well. Extract to send to doesn't work yet. Remove from recent, so let's see if we can do that. And that actually seems to have worked. Revert to previous version doesn't work because there's currently no previous version. See, it doesn't. But at least you can run the backup program. We'll test the backup program as well. But I guess we don't have the Nautilus encryption functionality, the Seahorse plugin installed, so we can't actually encrypt stuff from Nautilus, but that's not supported anyways either. So yeah, that's that. Oh, and actually, by the way, the functionality, the help functionality, works from all the programs. So this is the Yelp program, which should work from any program that has that is hooked into the GNOME help functionality. It's all confined. Oh, and let's just try that out. let's just oops, use help and use that to create a to do some printing. So for example, we could print this file in print preview, and the print preview works. This is actually the the events print preview program. So let's just actually print that to a file. So output PDF and print that. And now if you go to documents, there is this output. And the thumbnailing works, which I borrowed from Fedora. And then I can actually open this in the document viewer and actually use that. And document viewer help functionality should work. It does work. And then it has some new menus here. And hopefully that does work. I have to save a copy. Let's save a copy in my home directory. Output one PDF. Save. Could not save. Oh, this is a fake error message. So what it says here is, could not save the file to a home, my login user, output one PDF. And then it says error, setting extended attribute security as a Linux permission denied. But that doesn't mean it's actually saved. It's just barking. This is a wrong error message. It wanted to basically use ZFS createcon or something like that to create that file. But the file is there. If you look here, see, it's actually created. It says it couldn't create it, but it's actually created and it works fine. But it just couldn't use ZFS createcon to actually create that with the context it thought it would be right, because I wanted to override that. Actually, I don't want that. I don't want that program to actually be aware of SE Linux. It's none of its business. But that works. And what can I do with that? Okay, let's make a link. See if that works. Can create a link. So this functionality I really also need to fix. Let's move it to public. And now let's have a look if it's in public. And it's in public. So that functionality works. So yeah, that works. Now let's do some other stuff. Let's have a look at some other stuff. Transmission. Will transmission work? Accept. And let's try to get the latest Fedora. ISO. Let's download it. Where can I get it? More set of downloads options. Allow all or all download options, and then the torrent of the live image. So copy this bookmark copy link location, I guess. And open URL, and it's actually already in here, so that's nice. Open it and then to see if that works. So if all is well, torrent should work. Now it's still idle, I'm not sure why. Oh, there's 21 pairs. So we're getting there. Though it's a tad slow. Oh no, there we go. 3 megabits, 30 megabits, I guess. About 30 megabits. So that's downloading. It's it's actually 900 megabytes. That's more than a single CD. So that's about a gig. So that's going to take a while. I'll leave that open in the back. Other functionality we have. Oh yeah, so we have. What do we? Oh yeah, the disk uses analyzer. So you can basically look at how your disk is done, and here you can actually see. It's actually already saying that the size is 900 megabytes, but I'm not even done yet. Just started. So that's weird. I guess maybe it creates a file with zeros or something like that, and then you have cache. You see how cache is. So we have some tracker stuff in there. Thumbnails, we have them, and we have events of evolution already creating a lot of stuff. And that's, by the way, all nice and tidy confined. So ls all home my login user, and then see, this is all, it has private types except the desktop documents downloads, because that needs to be generic. That's the main idea. And when a user creates a simple file itself in its home directory, and it's also generic type. But if you look at cache, for example, cache, it all has nice private types, so it's all restricted and all protected. Same for config. See, nothing is generic. It's all it all has a nice private type. And same for local share, which, and those are the important layers for me to protect. Actually, that's where the stateful data is. For example, the GNOME keyring is, and config data is, and cache data is, which we like to basically protect. So yeah, that's all fine, nice and dandy. So this works, but if you, for example, try to list the whole file system, then you get a very weird representation. So it says permission that cannot scan folder slash, which is root. So, and then it can scan some stuff, for example, user, because it can't actually prevent that, because this program actually needs to be able to read user, share, and stuff like that to function. So it actually needs to at least have some access. Then here you see a lot of orange stuff that it doesn't have full access to, and even red stuff that it doesn't have access to at all. And here a lot of stuff that it can't access. So you don't get a proper representation here. Now alt root can't access that mount, it can't access that opt, it can, and this stuff it can't access. So close that. So it works to some degree. So the desktop ISO is almost ready. What else do we have? Oh yeah, we have a document viewer, but I already showed you that. So you can basically open a file here, open, and then look, go to my documents, and then there's that output PDF, and I can just open that. So you can basically just do that stuff. There's more. Image viewer. So let's just change our scene, if I can change my background. So let's wait for this thing to finish. So it's finished. I can open the folder probably. And now it's opened, and this is where my torrent is at. So the torrent downloaded successfully. So BitTorrent works. I can just close this, I guess, or I can just leave it there for seeding. But it seems I'm not seeding anything. So it seems that nobody's downloading. I'll leave it on for a while. So yeah, where was I? Oh yeah, this. So let's say we open an image, and we go to here we have some recent stuff. Let's go to user share. So the file system, user share, you can access that if you want to. User share backgrounds, and then Schrodinger cat. Well, let's just taken GNOME. Now let's just do this one. I can actually, there's no previews here. Well, let's just use this one here. So let's save this to our home directory. Save that there. And then go to our home directory, and then set that as a background. See if that works. Set as wallpaper. But that doesn't work. There's a bug there. It used to work. Seems to not work currently. So let's see what we have with regard to that. 4020. Sucks. Used to work. A GNOME shell cannot search pictures. What the hell is that all about? Why can't it search picture. And why would it want to search pictures? Let's just nano my login user TE and then go to gshell. So yeah, still a lot of bugs. It used to work in Fedora 18. But let's just add that here. User home T. It's not our intention to confine access to generic user home content, so it's no big deal to allow T shell access to search to traverse user home T, because that's not, it's not our goal to protect that generic content. It's our goal to protect the private content, and it's probably just only the beginning of a lot of AVC denials, I guess. Let's see if the if this changes anything. Set as wallpaper. Replace. Still doesn't fix it, I guess. See black wallpaper, so there's still issues. Read. It wants to read. Actually list there. Jesus Christ. It wants to list the wallpapers there. And actually also read the file. It's nasty. So let's just nano go back to gshell. Let's just fix that or fix that. So this, let's just undo this and make it read wallpaper and then just allow my login user. It's a pity, but like I said, it's not our goal to and also we need to verify this though there, and then it's basically getting attributes of it, get attributes, and it's searching it and it's opening it and reading that there, it's listing that wallpapers there. And then you need to allow it to actually read that file. Yeah, it's actually GNOME Shell doing that. So yeah, it's actually legitimate. Let's see if that fixes it. But that changed in Fedora 19. In Fedora 18, I got this to work without this access. But yeah, something has changed there. But in Fedora 18, it works. Now you see that it actually changed it. So let's try that again from the get-go. Set as wallpaper, replace, and then and have a look at AVC denials again at 23, I guess. And I thought I already allowed that reading there. Yeah, it's allowed. So yeah, that works. So that functionality now works. All right, let's see what else we have. So we have this image viewer stuff. I can use that image viewer to open a file in the home directory. So Here, this sunset, I can open that in Image Viewer as well. And save that and stuff like that, the simple stuff. Oh yeah, so this system lock stuff. Oh, let's first do system monitor. So this is the system monitor. And allows you to view the resources and stuff like that. Now that generally works. And then you can preferences and not everything works. You can't actually basically send signals to the processes. You can just only view them. Security context, show the security context. So you can only view processes. You can't actually kill them. So I tried that before and that was not permitted. So everything runs in nice domain. So if you basically view all processes, then you get a real weird view. So you get all kinds of empty stuff here. And there's no way for me to prevent that. So it's ugly, but at least it provides some security. So you can't actually see the processes of system daemons, but you can see your own process and you can also see the kernel threads, at least to some extent. And also some system services you can see, like for example ABRT and other stuff, some other stuff as well, not much. So yeah, it's at least some restriction there. It's not nice, not pretty, but it's better than nothing at all, I guess. So yeah, this works. You can have a you can look at the system resources, which is actually pretty heavy. And here you have how the disks are filled and stuff like that. So yeah, that works. You can actually share your desktop and see if that actually works. So share it require. Now actually, unfortunately I can't try that because I need to open a port ABC123 and the port is not open. I probably can't even test that. It probably doesn't even work, so I don't have to worry about that too much. This sucks. Where is my BNC? See, it can't. There's no network connectivity. It's not so much a issue with regard to SE Linux. See, although here IFNUM is trying to execute a binti file, grab binti, which is, what file is that? Shopl. Do you believe that? So IFNUM was actually trying to execute Shopl. That's something new, but it was prevented. So yeah, although it works, because if I look in the system monitor, then you can see that the Vino is actually running the session VNC server. Where are you? Vino server. See, it's actually running, but and it's actually confined as well, obviously. But I can't access it because there's some firewall rule there, and I can't do firewalling from this account because that's not supported yet, but I could at some point actually support that as well. So let's try another thing. So the archive manager we already tested that at least to some extent. I can just actually cancel, create a new archive, blah. and then add some files to it. And what do I have? So let's add this one, the sunset, to it. Add it. And now that should be created. There should be a blah thingy. Sure, yeah, here it is. So yeah, that works. That works. So there's some other functionality there. Let's just create some backup solution. So backing up. Oh, and it is actually doesn't quite work yet, but I can make it work. So let's just cut home my login user, and then SSH, and then pup. Copy this over and add this to Dominic. Copy this and then nano home Dominic SSH out. And then this can be removed, this one, and then paste that in. This is the new one. And my login user is allowed to actually connect to the system. So basically try that again. So I want to just show my backup settings. So let's set this up. Kind of forgot how that works. Less that and add something to backup. So let's say I want to back up my documents folder. And we'll use SSH for that. SSH. And then the server is SSH net KB info. And the port is 22. And the user is Dominic, not my login user, Dominic. And the username is Dominic. And back up now. Login anyway. And then this is basically enter password to unlock the private key. Not sure which key it is, but yeah, that's the private key to SSH in. The encryption password, and we'll just use ABC123. And remember that password. Okay, so that should have been backed up. We can verify that. Let's see if there's ABC denials. And at 30, there are ABC denials. SSH is trying to read the Kerberos. There, so I need to fix that. But yeah, I need to fix it. But let's just do that. A lot of new issues. So SSH. And it's actually SSH, yeah it is. So I'll just add that. This is SSH agent. I need SSH itself. I'll just edit here. So it's reading the dir, so yeah, I can imagine that it get attributes search and open. It's not reading it for its health. And then probably it wants to at some point also get to that file in there. There's an file in there. Shit. Oh, not this shit. Christ. Oh my God. I hate that. Screen. So yeah, now you know my screen password. And it's not even correct. Now, I totally don't have a clue what the hell I'm fucking doing right now. I just don't have a clue. Here's the screen. Password incorrect. Oh, that's the screen password actually. What a mess. But that's not actually it, is it? Quite the mess this. Quite the mess. Okay, so now you know my screen password. Need to fix that. Oh, and meanwhile, this shit. Once it's done. Now it's done. So, this directory, documents directory, should be able to refer to a previous version. So that works. And this is allowed. So it doesn't actually look inside that door, at least not at this point. So yeah, that functionality also works, I guess. And if you, yeah, you can actually now also log into the remote side here. So now you can actually see that here's that backup. Well, there's actually a lot of backups here, but this is the one that I'm, one of those is it. So that's actually works as well. Then what do we else do we have? Oh yeah, okay, so the system log. So this actually is a setuid application. Now I added myself to the wheel group, so hopefully it will ask for my login user password instead of the password for Dominic. Yeah, now it does actually ask for my own password. So so actually I'm running this stuff as root, I guess. So I can ps out grab my login plus, and actually it doesn't show up here because and here you have SSHD open and SFTP, you see it's open, firewall is still open, so all this stuff is still open, but you don't see it because it's actually root. So grab root, grab my login user. Actually, yeah, shoot, why isn't it actually in this list then? Oh, actually it is this. So here it should be, yeah, log view. So this is actually running as root, so this user, although he's very confined, actually has access to root, but only via this log view application. And also DBus Launch is also running it as root. Weird. And DBusD is running as root and dconf is running as root. But this is actually all related to that log view. Because as soon as I close log view, then these should probably be gone as well. So let's just close this and try it again. And actually they aren't. Shit. But anyways, those are actually related to that. But we have a lot of issues here though. So it wants to write to config and it wants to get attributes. So this is stuff that I really need to fix. But I'm not going to fix that now. So this is a little bit nasty currently, but you get the idea. But you can't actually run sudo or su from, that doesn't work. See, so you don't have to worry about that. You can actually only access root via that program. So now we basically tested everything that's in here, but except this one here, DNSSEC trigger, which basically will just add a new DNSSEC instance. So for example, if I now do ps aux grab DNSSEC, and now you have currently one DNSSEC instance, DNSSEC mon instance, but if I run it again, and the shitty thing is that I can't get the bar below here, there's a bar below here where this is running, but if I run it again, then you'll see that it's actually two instances right now. See, I just added a new instance of DNSSEC trigger, which sucks. It's basically really shitty. But anyway, so that's, I guess, all the functionality that I wanted to show you. So everything you see works, I guess. Seeding to two of two connected pairs with 0 KB. That's not right. 16 KB. 14, that's not much. And now if you look at the by the way, if you look at the password manager, you see that some stuff has been added. So the unlock password for my logging at Vert, and encryption, backup encryption password. So that works. That's all going on behind the scenes. So yeah, I think at this point I've pretty much ported everything to Fedora 19, every functionality that was supposed to work, except that there's some stuff, some loose ends with regard to LogView. I need to fix that. But nothing serious, I guess. But it's shitty thing is that now I have these processes hanging here as root. Let's see if I log off, if that makes any difference. I need to log off anyway, so let's just close all this stuff. So yeah, this is a confined desktop. And now it's gone, fortunately. I don't want any dangling. Except this Pulse Audio is still dangling there. Which sucks. But at least VD Agent is now shutting itself down. Except Pulse Audio isn't doing that. But okay. So yeah, that's basically what I wanted to show.